Senior number 15, Jay Halva. Boston's double is an All-American on the Pacific swim team in the 200-meter and 500-meter freestyle and was named a Golden Coast Conference All-Academic Team last season. Jay originally came to Pacific from just down the road at Delta College, where he was also an All-American on both the water polo and swim team. Moving into 2019, Michael has tallied 4 goals in 60 matches this season for the Tigers. Majoring in business finance, he plans to take time off after graduation to travel to Australia before he pursues a career in finance. Jay is accompanied today by his father, Lance Halva, mother, Christy Halva, and sister, Madeline Halva, and grandparents, Ken and T. Thank you, Jay, for all you have contributed to Pacific Men's Water Polo. For Ege Kola. Coming from Istanbul, Turkey, Ege has been an integral part of Pacific Men's water polo program since he stepped foot on campus. In his first year with the Orange and Black, Kola led the Tigers in goals with 49, tallying 17 multiple goal games and worked for finishing third on the team in points with 57 as he was named to the 2016 Golden Coast Conference Newcomer of the Year, Honorable Mention All-American, and the second team All-GCC selection. Following a successful freshman campaign, Ege continued to torch opposing defenses in his sophomore year, racking up 72 goals as he was selected as a third-team All-American and All-GCC first-team member. Last year, Kolak started all 24 matches for Pacific, registering 11 hat-tricks and 66 total goals, which helped him finish second on the team and earn his second consecutive third-team All-American honor, as well as a spot on the All-GCC first-team and All-GCC tournament team. Ege is the 10th Tiger in program history to be selected as an All-American at least 3 times. This season, Kolak currently sits third on the team with 39 goals and fourth in total points with 42. Majoring in finance, he plans to pursue a master's degree while also playing professionally in Europe. Our next Tiger senior, number 7, Andrea DeNardi. All the way from Nice, France, Andrea's 4 years with Orange and Black have been nothing short of spectacular. He's delivered in both a school and classroom, exemplifying the true definition of a student athlete. Following the 2016 freshman campaign that included 12 goals and 15 assists, DeNardi broke out in the sophomore campaign with appearances in all 27 matches, scoring 13 goals and recording 6 steals and 8 assists. Last season, DeNardi went on to set career highs of 23 goals and 26 steals while also adding 13 assists. Majoring in engineering management, Andrea plans to pursue a master's degree in engineering while also returning home to continue playing water polo. Andrea and Ege Kolak are joined today by alumni Iko Saito, Cody Scherer, and Reagan Retzloff, and Ege Kolak. Thank you, Andrea and Ege, for your continued dedication to this conversation. Our final senior of the day, number 6, Luis Araya. No stranger to the local area, Luis came to the Tigers fresh off an All-American career at St. Mary's High School in Stockton. He made an immediate impact at Pacific, earning All-GCC Honorable Mention and All-GCC Freshman Team accolades in 2016 after tallying 33 goals as a freshman with 15 assists and 48 total points. Tallying a career-high 41 goals, 41 assists, and 21 steals last season, he led the conference in play in 2018 with 10 total assists, averaging 2 per game, while also finishing third with 3.8 points per game, which was second only to fellow Tiger senior Luke Pavlar. Majoring in business marketing, he plans to pursue a career professionally overseas following graduation. Luis is joined this afternoon by family and friends, Trinidad Araya, Pablo Araya, Kathy Bonifield, Greg Bonifield, and Nick Bonifield. Thank you, Luis, for everything you've done for the Pacific Men's Water Polo Program. And Tiger fans, how about one more huge round of applause for our Tiger seniors? Thank you. Daniel Norman. Number 3, Skylar Lee. Number 4, Ivan Merten. Number 5, Casey Linton. Number 6, Carson Arnett. Number 7, Jason Ebsar. Number 8, Bryant Jowdry. Number 9, Grant Chiponis. Number 10, John Poland. Number 11, Zlatan Nikovic. Number 12, Tian Mobazita. Number 13, Sven Davidson. Number 14, Michael Sweka. Number 15, Chad Gournay. Number 16, Ian Lenore. Number 17, Foster Hoos. Number 18, Jovan Djokovic. Number 21, Jason Grew. And number 23, Samuel Worley. Anteaters are coached by Mark Hunt in his 15th season, and he is assisted by Bobby McDonald in his second season and Greg Hayes in his fourth season. And now let's meet the players for your Pacific Tigers. A redshirt from Fullerton, number 1, Jonathan Berry. A redshirt from Newcastle, number 1, Joey McLean. A freshman from Stockton, number 1, Lewis Gale. A redshirt from Hollywood, number 1, Michael Melnick. A junior from Kentfield, number 2, Wyatt Barker. A sophomore from Ottawa, number 3, Bogdan Jerkovic. A senior from Istanbul, number 4, Ege Kola. A redshirt from Perth, number 5, Luke Pavilar. A senior from Stockton, number 6, Luis Orion. A senior from Nice, number 7, Andrea DiNardi. A freshman from Montreal, number 8, Jeremy Cote. A sophomore from Irvine, number 9, Jonathan Cooper. A freshman from Stockton, number 10, Matthew Hosmer. A freshman from Belgrade, number 11, Jale Stanek. A redshirt from Park City, number 12, Eli Thalo. A junior from Huntington Beach, number 14, Eli Lule. A senior from Stockton, number 15, Jay Halva. A redshirt from Granite Bay, number 16, Christian Murphy. A sophomore from Carmichael, number 17, Aiden James. A sophomore from Long Beach, number 19, Sebastian DiGiampolo. And a freshman from Miami, number 21, Renee Peralta. The Tigers are coached by James Graham in his 12th season. He is assisted by associate head coach Joey Gillickson in his 5th season and director of water polo operations, Alex Natal. Now, Tiger fans, if you would please rise and remove your hats for the playing of the National Anthem. Thank you. Tigers goal, number 11, Jolly Stanis.
Come on. Yeah.
Rangers, goal number 8, Jeremy Cote.
Thank you. Thank you. want to welcome you guys back here for the second half of the UC Irvine Pacific Men's Water Polo match. For those that are just joining us, Pacific is currently up 12-2 here. Coming into today's match, Pacific's previous match, they had a win over at number 6 Long Beach State, winning it with a score of 13-12. The Tigers will finish out the final game of the year on the road at San Jose State before heading into the Gold Coast Conference tournament. Looks like Irvine will remain possession here. Excuse me, retain possession. Pacific will be wearing the black cap today with the orange trim and white numbers. And Irvine will be wearing the white cap with blue trim and blue numbers. Looks like the Tigers have been putting on a show here today, actually, with a big offensive explosion, putting up 12 goals. But not only that, putting up a good amount of defense, with Jonathan Berry only allowing 2 goals so far. And we have a Tiger goal.
Pacific Tigers goal, number 15, Jay
Alba. Looks like Jay Alba is going to get the score here and put the Tigers up 13-2 with 7:19 remaining in the third quarter. Tigers really keeping them out of the middle of the territory here. Irvine retains possession. Irvine looking to work up a play here as they kind of just keep passing around here.
UC Irvine goal, number 5, Casey Linton.
Number 5, Casey Linton is going to get the goal for that, which makes the score currently Pacific 13, UC Irvine 3. Beautiful day here today at Chris Kelton Pool. You wouldn't expect this kind of weather for a November day, but we're lucky to have it. Matthew Hosmer will have the ball. Dish it out to Jay Halva. Right in the front, and a Tiger goal. That's going to be
Pacific
going to Bogdan
Tigers
goal, Jerkovic.
Number 3, Bogdan Jerkovic.
This The seniors have actually been putting up big numbers today as they scored the first five goals of today's contest. And the rest of the team has basically been getting their fair share of the good as well.
Watch your low, John. Watch your low, John. Your low, John.
Pacific's really pushing them back far, but the officials are bringing them back in.
John, ask for the ball.
It's like Irvine's pushing the ball in. Looks like Irvine's trying to get an open shot here, but a big stop by Jonathan Berry, and another stop. And the ball will go to the Tigers. Rene Peralta with the ball. Giving up to Adon Jang. And a turnover for the Tigers. Ball will go to UC Irvine. Could be an open shot. Looks like they're trying to go for an open shot. Oh, big stop by the Tigers in the traffic, and the Tigers will come away with it. Long pass into the Irvine territory. Rene Peralta with the ball. And a turnover by the Tigers. 4:30 remaining here in the third quarter. Long pass into the offensive zone.
Hey, watch it. Drive ahead. Come on.
And they'll push it up further.
Timeout, UC Irvine.
And a timeout will be called here by UC Irvine. Coming into today's contest for the Anteaters, they are coming off a loss over at number 4 UC Santa Barbara with a final score of 10-15. So they're looking at trying to get something going here and trying to stop Pacific. But Pacific has other plans. Set to resume play here. Casey Litton with the ball, dishing back. Back to Casey. Back to the far side. Pacific really pressuring here, trying to stop the ball from going, and they do get the stop. And Pacific will push the ball up forward here. It looking for a shot. Oh, right above the goal it goes. And Irvine will take control. Wide open in the middle for Irvine. We got traffic going in front of the Pacific goal. But Pacific will come away with the offensive possession here. Luis Araya with the ball currently. Dishing it back to Araya. Pacific's looking to make something work here, working up a play, kind of passing it back around, but nothing will come of it as they turn the ball over. And another turnover as Pacific is going to get the ball back here. As everyone sprints back down to the Pacific offensive zone. And a shot and a goal.
Pacific Tigers goal, number 8, Jeremy Cote.
And Jeremy Cote is going to get the goal for the Tigers here. With 2:30 remaining here in the third quarter, the Pacific Tigers are up 15-3 over the UC Irvine Anteaters. As though Pacific really wants to put on a show here for the crowd for the final home game of this 2019 campaign. Irvine with the ball, dish it to the near side. Looks as though they could have a lane here for a shot, but Pacific is really staying close to the goal here to stop anything from going in. And it trickles through the hands of the Tigers.
UC Irvine goal number 6, Carson Arnett.
And Carson Arnett will get the goal here for the Anteaters, which gives their goal total up to 4 now. Tigers will keep possession. Jang with the ball. Dishes out to the far side. Ooh, big stop from the goalie for Irvine as they will take possession here. With the pass back, trying to get something working, and a big stop once again from Jonathan Berry. Clock is stopped because the ball did come out of the pool. Thank you. resume play. Looks like Irvine might have something here. Nope, they'll dish it right back to the goalie. Back to the middle, back near side, back to the middle. Pacific pressuring, traffic in the middle for the ball, and Pacific will come away with it. 20 seconds here left in the third quarter. Like we will have a timeout here. You'd have to think here that James has been proud of his guys all day, as they have looked sharp throughout the whole game. Really keeping possession, not really looking slowing down or anything. Seconds remaining here as the Tigers will look to keep it for the final shot of the quarter. Looking to work something around and try to get the open lane for a shot, and a stop from Irvine. And that will end it for the third quarter.
At the end of the third, your Pacific
At the end of the third
Tigers
quarter
15,
here, your Pacific
UC
Tigers
Irvine
have 15,
four.
UC Irvine
Tiger
with
fans
4.
Mark your calendars for December 7th and 8th as University of the Pacific hosts the Men's Water Polo NC2A Tournament. Game times are 5 and 7 p.m. on the 7th and 3 p.m.
Alrighty, we are back, and we are ready for the fourth and final quarter of today's contest. And it looks like the Tigers will win the open sprint here. As Irvine is really pressuring now because they need to get back on the scoreboard here to get this game closer. But of course, you would think the Tigers would want to pressure as well because they want to keep Irvine as far away from them as they can. And looks like we have a turnover and possession to Pacific. Stanich with the ball. And the ball will go back to UC Irvine. Lob shot for Irvine. Trickles past the goalie's hand and goes in.
UC Irvine goal, number 10, John Polos.
And John Polos will get the goal for the Anteaters, which now cuts their deficit. Pacific 15, UC Irvine 5. Back on the far side. Back to Araya. And back to Araya. Fires the ball through traffic and goes just above the goal. Good stop there from Jonathan Berry, as he has been aggressive all day. Stanich with the ball. Big shot and a goal. Coming from number 23, Luis Araya. Davidson with the ball. Irvine with possession, throws it into the middle of traffic and gives it up to Pacific. 5:43 remaining in the fourth and final quarter here. Pacific up 16-5, and they will turn the ball over and give possession to Irvine. Irvine dishes it to the far side. Back to the middle, back to the near side. shot and a goal for the Anteaters.
UC Irvine goal, number 7, Jason Evazard.
And Jason Evazard will be credited with the goal. Christian Murphy with the ball. Dishes is off to the far side too. I believe that is Matthew Hosmer. Back to the middle, and a shot and a stop from the Irvine goaltender. Dishes out to the lone man for Irvine, and a loft, and a stop from Barry. Long pass into the Irvine territory. Shot and a goal.
Pacific Tigers goal, number 3, Bogdan Jerkovic.
And Bogdan Jerkovic will be credited with that goal. Like I said before, once Pacific scored their first goal, they never really looked back. They just kept going. And that seems to be their plan of attack for the day. Irvine will keep possession. And scratch that, Pacific will take possession. And he's on a lone sprint here by himself. Wide open shot, and it goes in.
Pacific Tigers goal.
His first goal of the day for number 2, Wyatt Barker. Pacific really putting the pressure on, but the ball will stay with the Anteaters. I take that back. The ball will go to the Tigers. Deep pass into Irvine territory, and they will keep possession, and a shot and a stop from UC Irvine. Pacific will take the ball, work it back, look to get a shot here off the far side, and it goes in.
Pacific Tigers goal, number 21, Rene Peralta.
And Rene Peralta will get on the scoreboard here as well. With 3:18 remaining in the fourth quarter, Pacific is currently up 19-6 over the Irvine Anteaters. A wide pass that went to nobody. And Irvine will hold on to it. Pacific really putting the pressure on here. They want the ball back. and a shot and a goal for Irvine.
UC Irvine goal number 5, Casey Linton.
And Casey Linton will be credited with the goal. Four seconds left on the shot clock, and a shot, and that's off the bar. Keeping Irvine posted to the far side. They dish it back out to the middle. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. They're looking to get a shot here. 3, 2, 1. And it does not look as though.
You see Irvine goal.
Oh, yes, they will.
Ivan Merkep.
Ivan Merkep will be credited with the goal. Have the ball here. Shot and a goal for the Anteaters.
UC Irvine goal number 7, Jason Evizard.
Jason Evizard will get another goal here for the Anteaters as they cut the score down with Pacific at 19 and UC Irvine at 9 with a minute 31 seconds left. Pacific will keep it. Chang with the ball. Dish it to the far side. And Irvine will come away with the ball. Final minute here at Chris Kelson Pool. Irvine with a shot and off the top of the crossbar. And it looks like Irvine will get the shot here. Jason Evizard with the shot, but a huge stop coming from Jonathan Berry. Final 30 seconds here, and it looks like the Tigers are just going to hold this and burn the rest of the clock here. Ten seconds on the shot clock, but the Tigers aren't going to do anything about it. Shot clock violation, but it will do nothing. The final 5 seconds will tick away. And that is going to do it, folks.
And at the end of the game, your Pacific,
Pacific Tigers will come away with the victory of a final score of 19-9 against UC Irvine.
2019 home season. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram for updates on the remainder of the year. And Tiger fans, make sure you stick around after the match for a chat.
All right, I am here with head coach James Grimm. James, you got to be proud of your guys today as they put up an offensive explosion. How would you say they done the final home game of the campaign here and on senior day?
Yeah, our offense was tremendous, but honestly, I felt like the defense is kind of what sparked it. We've been really concentrating on trying to improve the defense, and we were able to get out and transition, and that was a big factor for us to be able to put up the goals that we did. Irvine's a great team, but we were able to push the tempo today, and I felt like that was to our advantage.
Very true. Yeah, like you said, very good on the defensive side. Jonathan Berry was very aggressive today, and he was putting up a lot of good stops. How would you fare that he did today?
Yeah, Berry is coming along, and he's playing better and better in the cage and getting more and more comfortable inside of our schemes. He was doing a great job not only blocking the ball today but coming out of the cage and being a versatile goalie and being a threat in a couple different ways. So, and he had a huge penalty block at the end. John Berry's playing really well, and that bodes well for the end of our season. Hopefully we can continue it.
And then finally, you guys have one more game here at the season as you go on the road against San Jose State before you guys head into the conference tournament. What are you guys going to have to do to really stay sharp and try to make a deep run this year?
Yeah, the whole nation's really strong. It's a wide-open field, which is exciting and also nerve-wracking at the same time. For us, it's just staying consistent and continue to improve our defense. If we can keep making strides there, which we have over the last few weeks, I feel like we're going to be in a good spot. So next week, San Jose, a great team. They're definitely fast and mobile. We're going to have to play a strong defensive effort, not just in the front court, but in transition as well. So we're going to have some work ahead of us this week, but I think the guys are in a good spot, and we're excited about the future.
All right, well, Coach, congratulations on the victory today. Your Pacific Tigers come away with a final score of 19-9 over the UC Irvine Anteaters. Have a great rest of your day, everyone. Please get home safely.